There exist a lot of problem-solving techniques, backtracking, dynamic programming, divide and conquer, and many other ones. Today, we will discover an interesting one that can be helpful when facing some problems, sliding window. There is a shelf of books, and you're allowed to take 5 contiguous books for free. And because you just care about money and not if books are interesting, you decide to take the 5 contiguous books with the highest total price. You start calculating the total price of each group of 5 contiguous books. The first one is this one. Its total price is 12 plus 9 plus 23 plus 17 plus 25. You take some time to calculate, you find 86. Then you move to the second one. The total price is 9 plus 23 plus 17 plus 25 plus 19. While you're calculating, you find 93, a better total price. You move to the third one, 23 plus 17 plus 25 plus 9 plus 4, wait, you find 88, not higher. Fourth one, 17 plus 25 plus 19 plus 4 plus 8, the total is 73, not higher. And now, while you just calculated the total price of 4 groups, there is another person that already found the best group and took it. How did he do? Did he know process before coming? Does he calculate faster than you? No, he just used a fast algorithm, based on the technique we're learning today. The mistake you did was that for each group, you was recalculating the sum from scratch. For the first subarray, you calculated 12 plus 9 plus 23 plus 17 plus 25. Then for the second group, you calculated 9 plus 23 plus 17 plus 25 plus 19. While the other person, notice that the difference between the first and the second group is just one element. Remaining elements are the same. Their sum doesn't change. So he took the sum of the first group, subtracted the element of the first group that is not in the second group, added the element of the second group that was not in the first group, and got the sum of the second group, without calculating the sum of all elements from scratch. In reality, the technique he used is called sliding window. Sliding window technique is a problem-solving technique that works by maintaining a window, a contiguous part of the data that respects the constraints. Then, we keep moving that window by extending it and shrinking it while respecting constraints until we finish the whole input. In our problem, the window represents one group of 5 contiguous books. We start from the first one. Then to move to the next group, we slide the window by extending it from the right by 1 and reducing its size from the left by 1. We're interested by total sum of all potential subarrays of books, and our window will traverse them all. And to update its total sum, we don't calculate it again from scratch. We just add the price of the book that entered the window and subtract the price of the book that went out of the window. In this example, initially we need to calculate the first sum, 12 plus 9 plus 23 plus 17 plus 25. We get 86. But to get the second one, we just take the previous sum, subtract the element that goes out of the window, 12, and add the one that enters, 19, we get 93. Then to get the third one, we take the previous sum, we subtract the element that goes out, 9, add the element that enters, 4, and we get 88. And so on until we finish the whole array. All that while checking if we got a higher total after calculating each sum. By doing so, getting the next sum now requires 2 operations only instead of calculating the whole sum again. And that's the case no matter the length of the window. Here it was 5, but even if we were dealing with groups of 1 million books, getting the next sum is done just by adding the new element and subtracting the old one. The size doesn't have an impact. Let's now compare both solutions. We have an array prices and k, the number of contiguous books we can take. We create a variable maxTotal that represents the maximum total price we found so far. It starts at 0 because we didn't start traversing groups yet. In the first solution, we were calculating the sum again for each group. Let's implement it. I represents where the actual group starts. The first group starts at index 0 and the last one at index length of prices minus k. so we traverse I in range 0, length of price is minus k plus 1. For each group that starts from index I, we calculate its sum. It's the sum of the subarray made of k elements starting from I, prices of I to I plus k. Now that we got the sum, we check if it's a sum that is higher than the highest one we found so far. Max total becomes max between its actual value and the total we calculated now. After the loop, we return max total. What about the sliding window solution? The difference is that we will calculate the sum once, then we just keep updating it to get the next one. The first sum is the sum of the first k elements of the array. We calculate it and we set it as the max total we found so far. Now for each subarray that starts at I except the last one, to get the next sum, we subtract its first element, because it will go out of the window, and we add the element that will enter the window, the one that is k elements away from I, at index I plus k. So we take actual sum, we subtract prices of I, and add prices of I plus k, and we get the new sum. Now we check if it replaces max total. Max total becomes max between its actual value and total. After the loop, we return max total. We can add an early exit condition at the beginning, to handle the case where n is smaller than k, where there is no group of k elements, we return 0. Let's calculate time complexity for both solutions. For the first one, we have a loop that traverses n minus k plus 1 elements, and at each iteration, we calculate the sum of k elements. The cost is k. We multiply, and we get an O of n times k time complexity, where n is the size of the array. While in the second solution, we have k to calculate the initial sum, then n minus k iterations for the loop. The difference now is that inside an iteration, we don't calculate the sum of k elements. We get the new one by just subtracting an element and adding another one. Two operations, constant, no matter the value of k. In total, we get k plus 2 times n minus k, which gives a time complexity of O of n, better than O of n times k. The difference in time complexity between both solutions comes from the fact that by using sliding window, calculating the next sum can be done in constant time, thus the impact of sliding window. We can even visualize the traverse elements at each step for both solutions. In the first solution, in the first step we traverse the first 5 elements to calculate their sum, then in the second step we traverse the next group of 5 elements, and so on. But in the second solution, at the first step, we traverse all the 5 elements to calculate the initial sum, the initial window, but starting from the next step, we just traverse the element that goes out of the window and the element that enters. That's it. We don't touch other ones. You can see that the number of traversed elements is way smaller in the second solution. Now we solve the maximum subarray of size k problem by using sliding window technique, but we can use it to solve a lot of other problems. One that is similar to this one is the maximum vowels in a substring of size k. We have a string s, and we want to find the maximum number of vowels in a substring of size k. A substring is a contiguous part of a string. Try to solve it and give me your solution in comments. We've reached the end of this video. I hope that you got the idea behind sliding window. If you want to support the channel, like and subscribe, or you can buy one of the courses in description. See you in the next video.